Hey everybody, Rob Woodbridge at with Untethered.tv, where we get behind the business of mobile. And I got a guest here who's actually one of the founders, or the co-founders of Yowza. It's Greg Grunberg. You might recognize him as Matt Parkman from Heroes. I want to talk strictly about the technology today. So listen, Greg, thank you for joining us today.
Rob, thanks for having me. I mean, this is what I'm, you know, this is a whole other side to my personality. I once played a character on a TV show called Felicity, and I played Sean Blumberg, this like entrepreneurial guy who always had all these crazy ideas. And J.J. Abrams, the creator of that show, and Matt Reeves, they are friends of mine. They know this side of me. No one else does. And now the world, hopefully, slowly, we're getting the word out. I mean, you know, Yowza is something that is an idea that I had. I'm always just enamored by the latest technology. I embrace it. I use it. I try it. You know, I was one of the first adoptees of Twitter, you know, in the kind of actor side of it. And that's why I think I have so many followers. I really think it's a matter of timing, you know, with Twitter. And I kind of caught the wave early. When the iPhone came out, and I've been a real Apple guy, but when the iPhone came out, and the apps started coming out, you know, everybody and their brother was thinking of what's the latest app idea. And it wasn't, I don't think, no, not everyone, but a lot of people obviously were on that bandwagon. Yep. And I just, it came out of frustration. Every idea that I kind of had was already being done, or I could see someone else doing it. And it wasn't organic to who I am. Elizabeth and I have three boys, and we shop. We're not incredibly frugal, you know, but we try our best to be. And we get those coupons and the you know, the things in the mail, and we never have them when we want them. And the truth is, it was Bed Bath & Beyond, which I don't think you guys have up there, but here it's this store that you do not go to unless you have the 20% off coupon. And the coupon they send out, it's literally that thick cardboard coupon, and it says 20%. So in the car, in our car door compartment, I have like 10 of them. So we're going into the store, which we shop at all the time, and we're with the boys. It's hard enough to keep track of the kids, and we're on our way in, and I forgot it in the car, and I was too lazy to go back to the car and get it. And I was like, literally like, why doesn't somebody harness the location-based technology of this phone? It knows where I am. Give me coupons from stuff. Give me offers that are right around me. Don't do it in an intrusive way like that, you know, the movie that everybody kind of refers to, the Spielberg movie, you know, or the Tom Cruise movie.
Yeah.
What was it? AI or whatever, or
Minority Report.
Minority Report, yeah. Minority Report. I don't want, you know, to be walking by something yet unless I choose and elect that. But I want those coupons. I want to say, I don't want to have to go and cut and paste. I want to save paper. So anyway, cut to 2 months later, and I'm on Twitter, and I get a tweet from a couple guys who want to get a hold of me because I have this charity band. Mm-hmm. They want to create an app for the band, so that people can check and see where we're playing and the latest info. And when they do that, money goes to our charities. And I thought, what a great thing. These guys don't want anything from me. I look into these guys. I checked them out, as I did you. And August
still showed up. Yeah.
August Trometer, who is now my partner on Yowza, is a genius. This guy has had apps before. He had like five apps already, right when the app store started. The other guy who got a hold of me, who's also a partner in Yowza, is Rick Yeager, who has Rick MacMurk. He's really super smart when it comes to social networking and everything Mac related. And so it was kind of the perfect synergy. I was talking to these guys about it, and I said, well, I've got this idea, you know, what do you think? And it was amazing because I'm literally looking at them on iChat, not on Skype, but it was like, they were here. We call ourselves the three hats because literally they're here and I'm here. And it was like, I said this idea, Rick's frozen.
Yeah.
Okay. But he's in Canada, so I'm thinking that's fine.
It's natural.
August is just a machine. He's going, I can see the wheel spinning.
Yeah.
August is thinking about all the analytics that we can gather and the shopping habits and all of that stuff,
absolutely,
which we'll get into.
Absolutely.
And Rick is thinking about the social media aspect of using my, you know, quote unquote celebrity and my access to getting the word out very quickly, which you need when you have an app idea. It was just a perfect partnership. And from that moment on, most of the work fell on August's shoulders. You know, we kind of made our laundry list of wish list and sent it to him. And he just really created, the first version of the app was rushed, to be perfectly honest with you. But we had to get it out there because I had tremendous PR opportunities to spread the word. And you cannot, in my position, you can't tell people it's coming.
Yeah.
They don't get it.
Yeah.
They don't get it.
Yeah.
So anyway, we got it up with the help of the people at Apple. We got it approved. You know, it took the normal amount of time, which is pretty fast turnaround, and they were great. And so far we've had tremendous success, and we've been really, really happy with it.
So you took a kind of a circuitous route, right? You started, went to acting school, did all of this stuff to you know, become an actor, an accomplished actor. And it's funny, my wife did mention that the role in Felicity as a tinkerer, as an inventor, and how, you know, art mimics life. And I thought, well, we're never going to talk about that. Don't worry about it. But it's true.
The first thing I mentioned.
Exactly. So she'll be happy. But you go through this whole process of becoming an actor to be able to sell an application. It's an odd way to market it, but I, you know, it's a unique way to do it. I've never seen that done in any of the other developers that we've spoken with. But so
Smule's done it a little bit.
Yeah.
With you know, with the voice altering one that they have, and then I Am Sam Jackson is an app.
That's
where
a great
Sam
app.
Just
yeah.
yells at you. You know, I mean, those are the thing that I love is what you said before we actually started the interview, which was that you've seen Yowza now kind of in a few places where you haven't seen me be mentioned. And that is to me, I mean, during the holiday time, we were alerted to this at the last second, 11th hour. Martha Stewart was on, and she was on with her, with this tech guru guy who's just really smart. And he's showing these latest apps that you can use to shop. He's showing Red Laser, and he shows Yowza. And she's like, Yowza, Yowza, Yowza. I can't even say it. And meanwhile, she's saying it 17 times. It was awesome. And they didn't mention once that this actor from a TV show co-created it. So it was wonderful. It's really taken on a life of its own, especially now. We have, like, you know, we're all across the country, and it's working. And it's and again, I hope we're not jumping ahead, but that was the key for the problem for us. It was a major hurdle, and it was sort of, don't put the cart before the horse. If I can get the word out nationally, it's a chicken and the egg. I'm using a lot of these terms. I hate that. I should start using quotes too, because that's obnoxious as well. But no, it was really a chicken and the egg situation. Look, consumers are not going to use it unless there are valuable coupons in their area that they can use.
Yep.
Merchants are not going to list their coupons unless customers are using it. So we had to overcome that. So I reached out to all of the friends that I had in any businesses that I had dealt with on a charity level, both, you know, like that have asked me to show up at a mall, or, you know, I've been a spokesman for, or whatever.
Yep.
But it was, if I couldn't get the word out nationally, it would have been a lot easier locally, which is what some other location-based services have done, location-based apps have done. So, but we've overcome that, and it's a constant, you know, hurdle that we're trying to just advance.
So, like, talk about that. Is that you've got over 15,000 vendors or stores, you know, involved in this? And I mean, what was the critical point for you guys to have it so that it would start to take a, you know, a life of its own and start to roll by itself? So you didn't have, you could step back and, you know, not do the door to door and make the calls.
Well, for us, it was we made a conscious choice, and this was more August's choice than anything else. I mean, August is just a brilliant guy. He's got a combination of tech savviness, incredible tech savviness, and also business savvy. Both of us, August and I, both had experience in retail, small retail stores. I had a frozen yogurt store, and August had a few bagel shops, muffin and bagel shops years ago. So we had that experience. We knew what it was like and how expensive it was to even hand a stack of flyers to a teenager to walk the neighborhood, knowing that probably halfway through he's going to throw them in the trash. You know, we knew that going in. But so we decided, August really came up with the idea of let's take the mall approach, and let's get some big anchor stores on board that we know have a ton of locations.
Right.
So, you know, Sports Authority, Finish Line, the Container Store was actually one of our first, if not our first. And these are stores that, you know, it's an interesting thing, this mobile, because you think about it and you go, wow, you know, this is amazing. But you don't use coupons to go get a beer. You just don't do it.
But could you? That would be great.
Well, you can. I mean, there are, you know, Foursquare and some of these other places where it's a game, you know, when it's like a social game. That's too much work for me. My wife likes it. I just don't like it. And, you know, it's not like I don't like it. I don't have time for it. I want to save money. I just want to press a button and use a coupon. But I'm not going to use a coupon at a bar. Friends of mine do. We have bars. We have restaurants. We have theaters. We have things. So it's, you know, right now it's very much a it's exciting, and it's generating interest in areas I don't think in retail that it when it settles we'll see, you know, where, you know, we're talking to some of the biggest chains and they love what we're doing. We're way out ahead of a lot of these other mobile couponing applications. So they're turning to us and we're about to announce some unbelievable partnerships. We just turned on, or we're about to tomorrow or the next day, 6,800 Jackson Hewitt locations.
Yeah,
because
incredible.
People need to save money when they're doing their taxes. And yeah. 6,800 locations. I mean, that's crazy. And we can turn it on with what August has set up, you know, like this. We could turn on one location just the same way. And yeah. So it's exciting in that way. But then Sears came on and Finish Line and Sports Authority and Guitar Center is actually, you know, they're scanning the barcode right off the phone. So it's stuff like this that makes it really exciting. And we're to a point now where we haven't reached nowhere near critical mass.
Yeah.
But there are some cities where we now have to think about categorizing. We did not want to categorize the app yet because yeah. there is a there's a benefit to being, let's say you're a shoe store and someone is looking for a discount on frozen yogurt. So they go through and they're looking for the frozen yogurt. And as they're scrolling through, like walking through a mall, I didn't know there was a shoe place on here. So you benefit from that.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, when we categorize, then suddenly you're just going to go food, yeah. frozen yogurt, got it. And you don't, you miss out on all this other stuff. So you can't please everyone. You know, there have been some obstacles in the app world. The rating system on you know, on the Apple Store is a disaster.
Yeah.
It is the worst possible system. And this is from the best possible company. They've got to get that together.
Well, it's amazing. So talk about that. Is that because of the influence that it wields? Like, I mean, when somebody rates you a 1-star or a 2-star, I mean, it has a massive impact on your ability to sell and be featured with Apple, or is it, what is it? What's the deeper part?
Yeah. Sell and be featured with Apple. I mean, we're a prize on the Wheel of Fortune. We're also a prize on the Price is Right and stuff. So, I mean, I have ways of getting around that. I would look,
you're not Apple's, relying on that.
No. And Apple's okay. been very supportive. I love those guys over there. Yeah. I mean, I really do. But yeah, it would be great, and that's been kind of the thing. Well, you got 3 stars. You know, you're not a 5-star thing. Well, so is the Apple apps. Apple apps are 2 stars, and it's interesting. It's like, wow, really? Oh, Kettle Black often, really? I mean, it's unbelievable. It's like, guys, your system doesn't work. The only time you ask people to rate on a 1-button rating is when they're getting rid of the app.
Yeah. I know.
When someone's getting rid of the app, they're not going to rate it a 5-star app. I love this app. I never want to see it again. It's like, it doesn't happen.
Delete.
Yeah. I mean, so they've got to do something. And the free apps are the ones that suffer the most from that. And all of our competition, it's the same thing. It's because it's so easy to get the app, lose it, get it, lose it. You know, when you're losing it, you know, you all. And by the way, if you hit no thanks, it also gives you like a 0-star rating or something. I don't know. It's just not. A good system.
Not effective.
But it doesn't affect us. You want to save money? There are hundreds of coupons on there.
Yeah.
Use them or not. And they pertain to exactly where you are. I'm not going to send you, or you're not going to receive offers in New York if you're in Toronto.
Right.
You're not going to get them in LA if you're in New York. You know, so it's only where right around you, and you can set the proximity from 1 mile to 50 miles. It's, you know, it's up to you.
Yeah, I mean, the app, you know, I certainly watched a bunch of videos of it and demos, and because I'm up in Canada, we don't have it yet. But, you know, it certainly is, it's comprehensive. Like, would you look out there and you say that you're so far ahead of the competition that this is now a platform?
Yes.
And when do you kind of win that war, which is the mobile couponing war?
You know, what's interesting is I don't think that there's really any winning. I think there's room enough for these stores to have their own apps. Mm-hmm. I think in addition to, look, you turn to Yowza, you know that you're going to save money. There's no question about it. Just because a store is listed on Yowza doesn't mean they're a discounter.
Yeah.
They just are putting offers on there that possibly upsell or introduce you to an area of the store that you wouldn't normally be familiar with, and they give you a little discount. To try that out, you know, if you're at Costco and you want to try the sunglasses, you normally wouldn't buy glasses there. Whatever, it's that kind of a thing that is how these people are dipping their feet into the water. But I don't think winning is ever going to look. You know, before mobile couponing, there's no clear winner. Everybody coupons. It's across the board. I think there's room enough for everyone. I just think that you know, our objective is to be on the bottom. Let's say take the iPhone as an example. That permanent you know, the bar at the bottom of it, you have four apps that you know you're not going to change. You don't flip from page to page. We want Yowza to be one of those for everybody, because if you spend money without checking with Yowza, you're throwing money away.
That's a noble goal, right? You know, because you do have 10 or 12 pages that you slide through on the iPhone. So now once you've got the person to download and install it and they haven't deleted it and given you one star and gotten angry with you, now how do you rise above the fold of the, you know, the 50 or 60 apps that typical people have installed? And
The way you do it is you make it really special. You create offers that kind of generate that Tickle Me Elmo frenzy, you know, and that we do through relationships. You know, I've voiced, I'm a voice on the Halo game, and I've voiced Time Shift and all these great games. I know EA, I know all these guys. So we will be coming out with a coupon in partnership with Stop, so that we'll have a unique offer just to Yowza. And that's really our job, is to make it so that you know when you open it up, you're going to see some stuff that is also advertised in the front window of the store. But that's good too. That tells you where and when the savings are. But there are unique things on there where you can immediately save $10 when you spend $50. You know, these are unique things to Yowza. The other thing that differentiates us, which we've, you know, it was a burden at the beginning to get over the chicken and the egg, but we insisted on doing it and we're going to keep doing it, which is we do not aggregate coupons. We will not ever put a coupon up. We don't put them up. The way Yowza works is, August has set it up, and we've now our whole tech department has set it up so that, you know, if you're a retailer or a merchant, you have access to getyowza.com. You log into your dashboard and you control your own offers.
Right.
That way we have catches in there, you know, so you're not going to write 100% off. It's only, you know, if that happens, we catch it and we alert you. You made a mistake, or profanity is caught. We have a Disney model. You know, there are certain things that we cannot and will not advertise on there, because stores are right next to each other based on proximity. So you can't have Hooters right next to, or a tobacco place right next to Disneyland. It's not going to work. So we have those kinds of things in place. But it's our job to just make it more, you know, make the incentives as much as possible for the consumer, so they'll turn to it every day. We are constantly working with the merchants. This is something new to them. They normally would just, you know, create a coupon and send it out, and it's in the paper and it lives its life, or it's in the mailbox, and if it's used, it's used. If not, it's not. These people can change their offers. If Pier 1 has a bunch of chairs, wicker chairs that are sitting, you know, in Minnesota in a store, they can put an offer up in the morning and blow them out for 50% off.
Yeah.
No one else is going to see it unless other than the people in that area.
Yeah.
Sell. At the end of the day, take that coupon off. Where else can you have that control?
It's so targeted. It's so targeted that you know, location-based stuff is incredible. You mentioned a little bit with Foursquare, Gowalla, these guys that are putting out these. You know, Gowalla is not as much of a game as Foursquare is. And I think you're going to South by Southwest, and I think that if you're going to see a lot of Gowalla down there, because they're from Texas I mean, they're trying to get into this, a little bit of this space where you become, you know, the mayor of a location, or if you check in somewhere close by, you get a discount on, you know, on a store that's around the corner, those kind of things.
Which is awesome. I think it's great. Yeah.
But do you ever see that kind of a good fit with what you guys are doing and working with their open API, that kind of stuff?
Yeah. I mean, we've partnered, you know, already we've partnered with Wear, which is a location services app. And what we plan on making additional partnerships. We're slowly reaching out to partners that we think could both benefit each other.
Yeah.
For us, it's, you know, we hold a tremendous amount of inventory that creates, you know, value for a Gowalla or value for a Ware, and Ware has the reach that we needed, you know. So if you have a BlackBerry, if you have an Android, if you have a Palm Pre, you download Ware, and one of the sort of apps in their app, you know, kind of thing, or one of their buttons is offers. When you hit offers, every one of the offers there, almost all of them are Yowza offers, and it's all location-based because their app is location-based. So we are very interested in partnering with Foursquare and Gowalla and all the really good, the guys that are doing it right and that are going to be around for a long time, and we're, you know, slowly reaching out to them. It has to be the right time. It has to be the right fit. We have to do it in a way that obviously, like I said, benefits both parties, but that's something that I'm really excited to do. Again, though, for us, the model is, and we did this, there was a thing called Under the Radar that we actually won our category, and it was based on simplicity. The real reason why we won is because we have taken, my side of this has been to August has said, look, I'm going to take care of the publicity. I'm going to get the word out. I'll get on the soapbox. I'll ride around on my horse and let everybody know every talk show, every time my band play, whatever I can do, I'll do it, right? But the app has to be Sandy Grunberg proof. And that's my mom. My mom cannot use this test app. Forget about it. I don't want my mom calling up going, what the hell? I don't have time to watch TV. Your show's confusing enough. I have to become mayor of something. You know, there's no way that my mom and these are the, we're talking about, you know, yes, there's a, you know, our age, young, I mean, I'm probably older than you, but the younger people are definitely, you know, they're into this and they love it and it's social. But once you're married and spending real money, man, you don't have time for that. You want to like hit a button, show your phone, save some money and you're out of there, you know?
It makes sense. I mean, yeah, the litmus test has to be, you know, simplicity. If you can turn on an iPhone, I have two kids, twin 3-year-old boys, and I hand them my, you know, when I had a BlackBerry, I hand them my BlackBerry and they'd push a button, the light would come on. I hand them my iPhone, they enable the device, right? They, they turn it on and they use the applications, they play games without me doing anything. And I think that you have to carry that simplicity over to the app, right? You have to make it as simple as a device.
It's true. Is my dad one of your twins? Because it's the same thing with my dad. It is. My dad like turns on the computer and he's like, but how does it work? I'm like, first of all, I don't know why you're talking with that accent, Dad. And secondly, don't worry about the inner workings. Yeah. This isn't the punch card.
Just push the buttons.
Yeah, push the buttons. Move your hand around. Yeah. I mean, honestly, I just know that the majority, again, when all the dust settles, you know, for us, it's interesting. We're in a tech world, but we're preaching and building a business that's been around since, you know, people were exchanging rocks in a cave. I mean, it's the same. It's such an old business. It is incentivizing people to spend money and go into the brick and mortar stores. Yeah. We have a few service-based businesses. We have a few. We're slowly working on product-based coupons. And, you know, there's a whole, you know, unique barcoding, all that stuff we're working on, and it's in our roadmap. But to put people back into the malls and give them a reason to, you know, to stand in a mall and go, oh, I had no idea that, you know, right down there I could save money at Sears. You know, that to us is exciting that people have the power of that in their hands. And then as a retailer, you can, you know, push an offer to somebody that has opted to see the latest offer from their store. We have that, you know, you can, if you're a consumer, you can say, yeah, you know, every time Guitar Center offers something new, I want to hear about it. And boom. That you'll get it on your phone, you know, and brag about it. We have the social stuff, you know, you can brag about it through email, through Twitter, and through Facebook. But again, we keep it simple.
You know, it's interesting because one of the biggest challenges, a lot of the folks that I talk to around, you know, the developers and the producers of these of applications is that there is that middle ground between, it's almost like a firewall between you and your users and the people who are buying the applications. Because really, especially on the iPhone only, Apple owns that information. And you've got to kind of find a way to circumvent that to be able to talk to your customers in one way, because you're not going to get it from Apple. So you guys have kind of come up with a unique way to be able to communicate with these guys on a personal basis, because they sign up for this information, right? When they want to know what's going on, what kind of sales are in their area. So you circumvent that wall, which is Apple. They still get their information and paid. Mm-hmm. Well, sort of paid, I guess. But then you guys get the information to be able to communicate with directly with the people who are involved.
Yeah, and it's non-intrusive. I mean, you know, although I like the idea of tying things to loyalty cards, mm-hmm. Again, loyalty cards are opt-in. You've chosen to become a member of that store. Yep. With Yowza, we ask you two questions, your gender and your age, and that's all when you sign up. And you can lie if you want. It's like, you know, you're not, and you are not going to get pushed coupons, or you're not receiving deals based on your age or, you know, your gender. People saying, they're like, I don't want to put... Literally, people are so fearful of Big Brother. They're like, I don't even want to tell them that because I want to see every offer.
Yeah.
People can be assured that Yowza, you press that button, it finds your location, and you get everything. We use the analytics. We use that information for the merchant, so the merchant knows when that unique ID that's that number that's that's tied to that phone.
Yeah.
That you know you're dealing with a male or female or whatever. And when the consumer says, yeah, I want to be pushed. I want to know when, you know, the Hobby Lobby has a new product or something in my area. That store in particular, when that store gets a new offer, I want to know about it.
Absolutely.
You know, so it works both ways.
So when you talked, you mentioned at the beginning about analytics, and I mean that what the information that you're gathering from all of this is so powerful. Like it's probably worth more it could be worth more than the actual couponing business, simply because you can gauge for any company, for any store, real time impact on sales. You know, and you can model that for them. Is that something that how do you use that information, or how do you want to use that information?
Well, currently, you know, like I said, we're gathering all that information, yeah. And exactly what you just said, as far as the value of that information, is what August said the first time I brought up this idea. Yeah. He was like, "That's going to be so much more valuable than the coupon business." And you know, it's slowly, Yowza is also just becoming an advertising platform.
Yeah.
You know, you will be able to save money on, you know, Yowza in other areas. Right now, it's all mobile and it's all on the phone. But we do gather that information. It's valuable to these retailers. They do not want to waste time. They don't want to waste money. They don't want to target to areas of the country where they actually aren't going to make the most impact for that offer. And that's another thing that you can, on the fly, each location can have its own offer. So if they can look at any time they go on and they can see where the offer is doing the best. They can track how many people are seeing it, viewing the offer, how many people are using the offer based on them sliding over the used coupon offer and seeing the code or the barcode. They compare that then, you know, because there's nothing that ties us to the register right now.
Yeah.
But they use that information and compare it to, if it's a unique offer to Yowza, how well it's doing, you know, in their POS system. And it's just incredibly valuable for them to become more and more efficient.
Yeah, forget the long, you know, the 30-day testing, ABC, you know, type of marketing. It's like, it's immediate. At the end of the day, you'll be able to know what happened in three different stores and three different sales and offers. That's...
Yeah, it's real time. I mean, that's the greatest thing about ours, is real time. And also, when they put up a new offer, these stores put up an offer, and I do this when I'm demonstrating. Like if I'm in a huge company, I'll sit and make a presentation, and then I say, okay, let's add an offer. So boom, 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 boom. I add the offer, and I ask them to give me the offer, so they know I'm not making it up.
Yeah.
I add it, and then I go, okay, check your phones. And immediately that offer is live.
Yeah.
That's so powerful.
Very, very, very powerful. And
yeah.
So when you started on the iPhone, obviously, you know, platform of choice, I think, for a lot of developers. And you just said before we started that you're now on the BlackBerry as well?
Yeah, through Wear.
Okay,
so through our partnership, we're working on Yowza for the BlackBerry, Yowza for the Palm Pre, and Yowza for the Android. But we wanted to get the offers on those platforms. So if you have a BlackBerry or an Android or a Palm Pre, you download Wear, which is free. Download that app and then press offers, and you'll see all the Yowza offers.
That's where you guys
are. And then as a merchant, if you're out there and you have a store and you think, I can't afford this, trust me, you can afford this. This is probably a quarter of what you'd normally. I mean, it's really, really reasonable, especially now we've done this self-sign-up thing where you can go on our website, getyowza.com, and you can just sign up. You don't even have to talk to anybody. You can put your own offers up. You give a credit card. It's a monthly fee. How we make money, our business model is a per location, per month fee. And you get five offers that you can put up.
Per location.
So it's very, very, very cost effective. You're not going to get a bill saying, well, you added, you know, 17 offers this month, so that's times three. It's not like that. It's a monthly charge that's very reasonable. I could never, for my little frozen yogurt store, could never, ever have come close to spending this little and reaching this many people.
It's pretty remarkable. It's kind of democratized this kind of couponing and advertising and marketing, hasn't it, the technology?
Yeah, and it's very egalitarian because everybody can do this. It's not like you have to be the big chain to be able to afford the infrastructure, the technology. There is no approval on an offer. There's no artwork involved. There's no, you don't have to spend any money. There's no machinery to buy for your store. It's literally fill in the blanks. You've seen it. I mean, I'm sure in the demo.
Yeah.
It's fill in the blanks. Here's the title of the offer, the details of the offer. Do you want to limit the offer to number of times that a person can use it?
Yeah.
And there's an expiration too. So you look at an offer and it says like Fantastic Sam's, you look at me like, I'm going to get my hair cut. Oh, the offer expires in 2 days. I got to go in now.
Yeah.
So it you know, it gets people pumped up and it gets the stores, you know, their immediate sales when they need them.
Sense of urgency. So I always have this, you know, I'm intrigued by you. I mean, you've got certainly multiple jobs, right? You named a number of them, and we all know what you do for your day job. How much time do you devote and effort do you devote into this company? And then what other companies do you think that, like, is this something that you're just going to continue doing, is starting these companies when the appeal is there?
This is something that these ideas, an idea like Yowza,
yeah.
And August and I talk about this, and it's, you know, I guess it's grandiose, and I don't want to sound like, you know, I'm preaching or whatever, but it literally can change the way people shop.
Sure.
And save money. So it's not, that kind of an idea doesn't come around every, you know, once in a lifetime, you get an idea like this and you can really take it to the level you want and possibly sell it off or whatever. I devote every minute I can outside of the other projects that I have that are, you know, heroes. As an actor, it's very demanding when I'm working, when I'm shooting. But when I'm not, I have off time and I'm always business minded. I my wheels are spinning. And so this is a really great outlet for me. And it's a way for me organically to, it's a little William Shatner. I mean, I know that, you know, it's like, hey, dude, you're an actor. Don't tell me how to save money. I don't need you telling me about, you know, orbits or whatever the hell it is. But at the same time, it is organic to who I am. I'm a family man. And that comes first. And I've got my kids and I want to save money. So it all works in my story in talking about it. But I've also got the band. Our oldest son has epilepsy, and that's a big thing for me is raising awareness. I started talkaboutit.org. If you haven't gone to the website, please check it out. Epilepsy and seizures are something that are there's a stigma attached. We don't talk about it. If we talked about it, you wouldn't be fearful if you saw someone have a seizure, nor would you be fearful to tell coworkers. So God forbid you have one. You know, if you have epilepsy, people know what to do. It's not that scary. So I started that, and my band is an outlet for me. It's a great outlet. We've raised over $2 million over the last 3 years. So it all comes together, you know. Loman's, for example, is a great chain. They're on Yowza. They have a grand opening of a store. They could hire anybody to pay. They're paying us a ton of money, and it all goes to charity. And then so here we got Yowza, my band, the acting side of it with all my acting friends, and the charity side all coming together. And, you know, so I don't know. I don't have a lot of free time because I'm in bed cuddling with my kids. That's what I do. You do it too.
Yep.
You got to do it, man. It's the most important thing, but I love keeping busy. And you know what I think this actually comes out of is as an actor, you have about 5 minutes a year. Even in my position, I've been on 3 successful shows. I get about 5 minutes a year to have control over my career where the network or the studio says, we'd really like you to do this.
Yeah.
So then literally I get a call from my lawyer or my, my agent going, they need to know right now. And that's it. It's either, if I say yes or no, do I say no? I mean, there's some times as people will attest that I should have said no, but it's hard as an actor. So this is something I have control over this. I can go out and raise money for charity and no one's going to tell me it's not successful.
Yeah.
$1 or $1 million. I don't care. It's helping people.
Yeah.
And Yowza, I just get on the phone and call these guys, man. And these CMOs, they get on the phone with me because I say, hey, it's Greg Grunberg from Heroes. And they're like, what? They pick up the phone. As opposed to someone else who might be in my position at another company, they're getting bombarded right now. Yeah. I'm calling from Gwala and Hawala and Yalala and Jadawa and Yowza.
Right.
What? What are you talking about? So, it's good. It's an unfair advantage, but I'm using it.
I mean, if you listen to any of the other guys that I've spoken to, it's always the issue about how to create awareness, and it is, you can take the top down approach, which is kind of incognito for you, and just be an investor, a silent investor, but that's never going to work. Like what I get from you, Greg, is that you dive in. I mean, you're passionate about this idea, you love the idea, it fits into what you want. It instills a sense of normalcy, and this is a business that you think can grow, and I think that can revolutionize the way that you purchase and you buy things, especially when it gets up to Canada. So you have to have all of those things, and then to leverage what you've got, that's just a natural extension.
Yeah, I mean, people, look, I have 1.5 million people following me on Twitter,
Yeah.
and they're used to scatological humor and poop jokes,
Yeah.
you know, and occasionally seeing the size of my steak when I order it at the restaurant,
Yeah.
you know,
I saw
and
that
then,
carbo
yeah,
loading.
so,
Yeah.
exactly, so suddenly they get, it's like, yowza, yeah, people that don't know, they're like, yowza, are you getting paid by this company to preach about yowza? And I have to, and I take advantage of that. I'm like, no, yowza is an application that's free.
That's
You know, I'm like,
right.
hey, thanks for asking. Now I don't have to preach it. But it's a balance. It's a delicate balance. I don't want to abuse, you know, any sort of a soapbox that I might be able to stand on. But at the same time, it's free and it helps people. And, you know, it's a business that I really, really enjoy. I so enjoy talking to guys like you. I love working with August, love it. Rick, love it. I mean, these guys are. If I let's put it this way. I've been very, very lucky in my career, and you know, this is nice. This could be a monster success, and it's on its way to doing just that. But I don't have to do this, and I love working. I love the excitement of it and building this business, and I happen to really love the guys that I'm working with. So it's all working.
I see, Greg, that's a great lesson. I don't know if we could end on a better note, because it is, I mean, if you don't have that passion and that love for what it is that you're building, it's gonna show. If you can't communicate effectively why you like what you're doing, it's gonna show, and people aren't gonna believe the sincerity.
Yeah.
And if then you've lost those customers, right? And you've lost them for good. And so I think that's a great point to kind of to end on, simply because I mean, I could speak with you for the rest of the day, but I'm fairly certain that you don't want to speak to a guy up in Canada for the rest of the
You'd be
day.
surprised.
That's right. Well, maybe one
I
last
got
question.
three screaming kids back at home. You know,
So
it's
I
like,
got two upstairs as well, so
yeah.
it's okay. One, I mean, how does when you're doing stuff like this, like you know, coming onto Untether, or doing anything around Yowza, I mean, what's the reaction, you know, in your other line of work, in the acting side? Does your agent kind of say, well, you know, you've got to be over here, you've got to do these things, or is this really truly your time to be able to do these things?
What's really interesting is the timing is really right for this because the you know I would say maybe 10 years ago people would be like, look, make a decision.
Yeah.
Do you want to be an entrepreneur or do you want to be you know? And I think now more than ever, just with the vital nature of what this ties all in. I mean, this is you know it's right in your pocket, but you can also watch Heroes on the
Very nice.
same device that's giving you know this coupon or. You know, that it all works together in a way that, plus it puts me, just selfishly, to be honest, you know, it keeps me in the public eye.
It's your
And
brand.
yeah, it's my brand, and there's nothing wrong with that. And it enables me to also get the word out that, you know, I'm not going to be pushed over. You know, it's like I've got my own stuff and I'm working on it, and I really enjoy connecting. And, you know, the studios used to flip through People magazine to see who's the hottest. Now they go to Twitter and see how many followers you have. So it all ties in, man.
It's pretty
And
amazing.
you know, and Yowza, stuff like the Yowza or the band or well, not really the band because we give all that money away, but like Yowza, just as far as just to be perfectly honest with you, it frees me up to not have to, you know, take every job that comes my way. And I've been extremely, extremely lucky that I've worked with the best people. Really, I've been so fortunate to be able to work with J.J. Abrams and Tim Crane and these guys. I mean,
Pretty
they're just
amazing.
amazing. So now I can be a little bit more choosy because I've got a business that's working and I enjoy what I'm doing. So.
Well, look, Greg, I truly appreciate your time to sit with me today and kind of and share the Yowza story, share your story. Really do appreciate this, and I will look forward to the day that it comes up to Canada, and then I'll ping you and let you know my true thoughts on using it. But it's something that I would use, and that's what this is about, is to make sure that you can endorse the products, and you're certainly a ringing endorsement for your own product.
Thank you. And thank you for letting me talk about a little about the charity stuff and really to talk about the inner workings of this because, you know, people see it and they're like, oh, he's just attaching his name. That's why I love engaging in a conversation that's an intelligent one and one that shows that I can show people that I really am truly passionate about it. And I'm the one doing this with some very, very, you know, whatever it is now, 14 really, really smart people. You know, it's not just, I'm not just a figurehead or somebody that, you know, goes on and says, hey, I use it and get paid for it. You know, I mean, you know, I've done that over the years too, but this is something that I really do enjoy, and I've been responsible for, you know, at least half of it. You know, I can't take credit for the tech side of it, but you know, it's been a great partnership so far.
The awareness. Well, listen, Greg, so it's at getyauza.com. And what's your Twitter address? It's just at Greg Grunberg.
At Greg Grunberg, yeah.
Okay, so we'll see if we can get you 3 or 4 more followers.
That'd be awesome. That'd be awesome. And anytime, man, anytime you have any question about anything mobile and you just even need a soundbite or whatever, call me. I mean, that's what we're trying to do with Yauza, is be sort of that platform that says, well, Yauza thinks this, Yauza thinks that. You know, we've got some really smart people over here. And if it's not me, it'll be, you know, someone else can talk to you. It'd be great.
Well, that's amazing. I appreciate that very much. Listen, Greg, thank you so much for doing this, man.
Thank you.
All right. Take care.
Talk soon.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.